Hello friends, welcome back to my channel, The Indian Mom's Kitchen. Today's recipe is a premix recipe. Today I'm going to show you how to make a sambar premix and store it in your kitchen for at least 3 to 4 months. And from this premix, without adding anything more than water, you can make a sambar in 10 minutes. This premix is also handy if you have children studying away from home or working away from home. This is something that you can make and send it with them. It stays good. If you're keeping it in the freezer, it will remain good for 6 to 8 months. This is something that they can instantly make sambar with and is very handy for children or even people working away from home can have home cooked sambar readily in 10 minutes. So let's begin today's recipe. For this, I've heated up a pan and I'm going to dry roast chana dal 1/4 cup. Urad dal 1/4 cup, tuvar dal 1/2 cup, rice 1/4 cup. Rice, any short grain rice will do. Now dry roast all of these things together on a low flame till a nice roasted aroma is emanating from this mixture. The color won't change much, but you'll get a roasted aroma from this. I've spreaded it out on a plate and allowing it to cool. While this is cooling, let's roast the spice mix too. For that, in the same pan, I've taken 1/2 cup of dhania seeds or coriander seeds, 2 tablespoons of black pepper, kali miri, 2 tablespoons of jeera or cumin, 1 tablespoon of methi or fenugreek seeds. Start dry roasting them on a low flame. To this, I've added 10 to 12 dry red chilies. I have the spicy variety, so I've just added 10 to 12. A handful of kadi patta. Continue roasting this mixture. I'm also adding 1/4 cup of desiccated coconut. This you try and add it towards the end because this browns faster, so it's better. Once your spices are nearly roasted, then only add the desiccated coconut. How well should you dry roast your spices is you can check by trying and pressing a kadi patta. If it is crumbling like powder in your hand, your spices are ready. Keep it aside to cool. In the meantime, let's powder the dal mixture. I'm transferring this into a blender. Powder this coarsely. Doing the same with the remaining of the dal. So your dal mixture is ready. Now for the spice mix. There are a few things that were not added initially. I didn't have Kashmiri chili, so now I'm adding Kashmiri chili powder 3 tablespoons. Haldi 1 teaspoon. I'm adding the spices little by little and trying to grind it to a very fine powder. The spice mix powder is ready. Now combine the spice mix with the dal powder and mix well. There are a few things which I haven't added till now. That is, one is the hing, which is very essential in sambar, hing or asafoetida. You can add at this point around 4 teaspoons of hing powder. But what I find is that as this premix powder sits, it loses the aroma of hing. So I try and add it when I'm making sambar each and every time. Then you just need 1/2 teaspoon or so of it. That's one thing. Another thing is, normally we add tamarind. So you can actually roast your tamarind along with your spices and then powder that along with it. But I usually like to wash my tamarind. So I'm going to add it when I'm making my sambar. But if you don't want to add tamarind fresh, but you still want to have the sourness in your sambar, you can also add amchur to this at this point. That is also a possibility. To this, I'm adding 2 tablespoons of salt. Salt not only adds to the taste, It acts as a preservative to keep this premix fresh for at least 3 to 4 months. Mix well, combine everything very well. Your sambar premix is ready. Store it in airtight containers. It remains fresh for 3 to 4 months. Now to make the sambar, it is ready in 10 minutes. For that, I've taken 2 tablespoons of oil in a pan. Heated it up, added 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds to it, 1 tablespoon of urad dal, 1/2 teaspoon of jeera or cumin once the mustard starts to crackle. Today I'm making bhindi sambar, so I've taken a cup of chopped bhindi, I've added to the oil. I'm going to saute this for at least a minute. You can make the sambar with any vegetable of your choice, or you can also make it without vegetables. You can just add onions and tomatoes to it and make it. So once this is sauteed for a minute, I'm now going to add 1 tomato, chopped roughly, and 2 green chilies, a few kadi pattas. Saute again for a minute. To this, I'm adding 1/2 a cup of the sambar premix. Mix well. I'm using 3.5 cups of water now. Mix everything and let this come to a boil. While I'm waiting for this to come to a boil, I'm adding tamarind water. I had soaked a small bowl of tamarind in 1/2 a cup of water. I'm going to just strain it through my fingers and adding that tamarind pulp to the sambar. Half a teaspoon of hing or asafoetida. 1/2 teaspoon. Once the sambar comes to a boil, let it simmer for around 3 to 4 minutes. I checked the salt and needed a little more, so I added a little more salt. 1 teaspoon of jaggery, this is optional, but the jaggery balances the flavor very well. You can see your sambar thickening up slowly. Your sambar is ready in under 10 minutes. I'm garnishing it with a few coriander leaves and taking it off the heat. Here it is, your sambar premix along with the sambar we just made in under 10 minutes.